Assistant, I need to see you for something.
Oh, hell no. I have a name and you are gonna fucking use it.
Hope, may I please see you for something?
Much better. What can I do for
you? Are you always this snippy? You had such a glowing reference from Hephaestus, and I cannot for the death of me figure out why.
I am delightful and cheery always, but I refuse to be disrespected in any way, shape, or form, and that includes by you. Now, what can I help you with?
This note on my schedule, T3, what does that mean?
Ah, that is not a T, it is a cross, and it stands for the Holy Trinity. You have a meeting today with God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit.
I see. No, I will not be attending that.
It's not optional.
Anything is optional if you opt not to do it.
You've been putting this off for several millennia. You have to go.
They can have their meeting. I simply will not attend.
Are you doing this out of spite?
Excuse me?
Aw, is someone still butthurt that they got kicked out of God's house?
You cannot speak to me that way.
Someone has to.
What was that?
Nothing. When would you like me to reschedule the meeting for?
When pigs fly.
I didn't know you could fly!
Out! Lucifer?
Yes?
Oh! What are you doing?
Hiding.
No shit!
God is here and is looking for me. I thought I had you reschedule the meeting I had.
I did! But I did also remind you that you haven't met with God in a long time, and that you can't keep putting it off, and now it seems to be biting you in the ass.
Did you send him here to meet with me?
No! He would never do that.
For some reason, I'm truly struggling to believe you.
You have the entire afterlife to hide from God, and you chose under the desk in your own office.
I may have panicked.
You know, you're stupid sometimes, right?
Get rid of him.
All right.
Hey, he's in here.
Damn it, Hope.
Play stupid games, win stupid prizes.
Lucifer, your presence is currently being requested at a seance in Salem, Massachusetts.
Why do the mortals try to summon me during these seances? That is not what they are intended for. They are intended to summon deceased mortals, not the ruler of hell.
I am aware of that, but it appears that the folks doing this seance are all around the age of 14, and their medium is a certified quack.
I'm beginning to feel bad for these mortals.
So I'm assuming we're going to be declining the invite to join?
Of course. If I attend one seance, then I'll be forced to attend them all, and then we'll never get anything done.
I completely agree.
Salem, Massachusetts does seem to be a common place for these type of rituals.
People want that witch trial street cred during spooky season.
Is it not only September?
I don't get it either.
Did you ever participate in a seance?
Absolutely not.
Not surprising, I'm not even sure why I asked.
What's that supposed to mean?
You don't exactly have the personality of a ghost whisperer.
I can do it!
By all means, join that seance.
I wasn't the one invited.
That has never stopped anyone.
I can visit anyone in the entire afterlife. I don't need to join the mortals to talk to the dead.
You keep telling yourself that.
You're mean today.
Just trying to keep you on your toes.
I'm just gonna record this because I think it'll be funny. How does one throw a book at their face? Just... I'm like scared. Oh! I'm like really prone to nosebleeds. This is a bad idea. Okay, I'm gonna try and throw it like flat, like face to face, because I tried this and the corner hit me in the face. Like right here, and I bet I'm gonna have a mark on my face now, so that's fun. Oh! Does that come off on camera?
Come get your love. Come get your love.
Oh, I missed my face! So, there's makeup on the... Right in the face!
What is on the agenda for today?
Well, some of the demons on the torture levels are unhappy with the equipment that they have to use.
There is nothing wrong with the torture devices at their disposal. There are plenty of options to choose from.
They have a guillotine.
That is an amazing torture device. What is wrong with the guillotine?
Well, the device is old and difficult to maintain. And honestly, it's not the greatest torture device. I mean, it's used for a nice quick death, but after death...
I never considered that.
And then there's the equipment that needs upgrading. You've got multiple swords, flamethrowers, bone saws.
I swear I just got them new ones.
Yeah, over a century ago doesn't count.
Has it been that long?
Oh, one of the demons has requested a knife glove like the one that Freddy Krueger uses.
Who?
That's embarrassing.
Tell them I will think on their requests.
You do know that for the souls to be tortured, you need demons on staff to do the torturing.
And I do.
And they won't work if their requests aren't met.
They'll have to deal with it.
Note to self, get HR down here to discuss management. Good morning!
Why are you so chipper in the mornings?
Chronic fatigue does not exist in the afterlife, so I am soaking up every ounce of consciousness that I possibly can. Side note, what's going on with you?
I was challenged.
Like a duel?
Something like that. Loki challenged me to a battle of wits.
Involving alcohol?
An excessive amount of alcohol.
The god of mischief battled you to a drinking challenge, and you actually thought you were going to win.
I did win, as a matter of fact.
You certainly did not.
I drank Loki under the table.
Okay, seeing as how I just ran into him on my way in here, and he looks right as rain, I'd say you definitely lost.
That bastard.
If it helps, you certainly look like you had a good time.
Please don't help.
Hope, what was your mortal birthday? Specifically, what time? What do you need to know for? I'm curious about this astrology thing that Western civilization is so fascinated by. So much of the world is obsessed with astrology, the Western Hemisphere cannot take all of the credit. Perhaps I should read more into the history, but you never did answer my question. Date and time of your mortal birth.
September 22nd, between 2 and 4 in the morning, but I couldn't tell you which time.
According to this chart, you are a Virgo sun, a Capricorn moon, and a Leo rising.
And what does that mean?
I have not a clue. Do you know?
How in the fuck should I know? You asked me!
It is supposed to be indicative of one's personality.
Did you actually need something, or...
Hills Resources, Leviathan speaking.
Lev, it's Hope. How you doing?
Hope, my dear. Congratulations on your new position.
Thank you so much. You know, Lucifer is a pain in my ass, but I'm a pain in his, so we balance each other out.
What could Leviathan do for you?
Well, we are needing some new and updated weaponry for the torture levels, and Lucy's being a little bitch about it.
You need new weapons? Updated weapons? Who's complaining?
All of them. Like, I have a stack of requests high enough to make me anxious just by looking at it.
Everybody. Let me guess. He's using stuff like the rack still, and saying it's new.
It's old as dirt, I swear. I mean, honestly, mood.
Let me see what I can do. You might want to get a hold of Hephaestus. He can probably get you some really good stuff. I've heard he's quite good at building things.
Eh, you're not wrong. He built me the rolly chair for the office. It's my new favorite toy.
Yes, I know. He's one of our most skilled builders in all the afterlife. Someone said, though, there are some new advances in laser torture, if you'd like. Or use bikini wax. That's always a good one from what I've heard.
Yeah, you're not wrong there.
All right, my dear. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much for taking my call.
It's always a pleasure to talk to you, Miss Hope. Let me know if you need anything else again.
You got it, bud.
Thank you, my dear. You have a pleasant day.
Bye. What? Okay, I have got everything. All right. All right, Lucy, I'm taking off. I'll be seeing you in a few days, all right?
Whoa, a few days?
Yeah, I told you I was taking a few days off. I told you this like a week ago.
I don't recall you telling me.
I'm almost certain that I did, but I'm gonna be honest, forgetting to tell you sounds like something I would do.
Why are you even taking a few days off?
Well, a relative of mine just arrived to the afterlife, so I'm taking a few days off to hang out with them, spend time with them, really just kind of help them get adjusted.
Damn, that's really nice of you. But still, I would prefer to have you here.
Now, I know that you know that I could not care less, but I'm curious, are you really just gonna miss me?
I'm going to miss someone assisting me through the day-to-day tasks. Work has become much less stressful since you've arrived. Oh, goodness, I'm going to be subjected to your cheerful emotions.
I'll tell you what. Let me reach out to a few friends, see if I can't find someone to cover for me for the next few days, all right?
That would be greatly appreciated.
You're welcome. Now let me see what I can do.
Delaney, the phone is ringing.
Yeah, it's really annoying.
Did Hope inform you of the duties that come with this job?
Duties.
Jesus. Answering the phone is a part of the job.
I don't like answering phones. It's hard.
Hard?
Hard.
You're just laughing at your own jokes now.
Can't you just answer your own phone?
I am currently working on our expansion project as more souls are being sent to hell than we had initially anticipated. Did Hope even tell you why you were here?
I'm like a substitute.
And you have to do what she does while you're here.
My substitute teachers always let us have free time.
And I'm so sorry that you were a part of a failed education system, but you have to help me with the day-to-day tasks.
Fine. Hello. Nah, he's not available. Okay, bye.
Who was that?
Not sure.
I wish you had taken a message.
You just said to answer the phone. You should have been more specific. Well, Delaney's fired. How long did she last? I'm impressed. She lasted about 45 minutes. You're pure evil. Lucy should know that by now. This is really on him. Are you Lucifer?
That depends on who's asking.
My name's Rebecca. Hope asked me to come and cover for her while she's out of office.
Did she inform you of what the job entails?
Yeah, she told me all about it. I just have some concerns and expectations.
Expectation? Can you elaborate?
Yeah, I had some things I need to go over with you before we begin.
You will be responsible for assisting me with day-to-day tasks. This includes making and taking phone calls, scheduling meetings and appointments, and checking in on the demons and coming to me with any of their concerns or requests. Although it is unlikely that you will have to do any of that, as you are only here until Hope returns. Does that seem like something you can do?
Yeah, she explained all that, but I need to discuss the terms of the job.
Terms?
Yeah, so I'm gonna be requesting benefits. Medical is a must.
vision and dental a plus. I'm going to be requiring 8 weeks of paid vacation per year. I know that seems like a lot, but I think you can handle it. I'm going to be needing adequate breaks with a paid meal every shift. And then speaking of the pay, is it going to be weekly or bi-weekly?
Please excuse me for just one moment.
Hello?
I know what you're doing. Stop doing it.
Excuse me?
Find me someone competent.
Rebecca is perfectly competent. She knows her worth.
Pick someone else.
You know, he really ought to just pick someone for himself. He's just a lazy fuck. Any updates?
You have an email from her.
Let me see.
Ah, so the E in this word is going to make the short E sound. So instead of Hera, it's Hera.
Hera.
She must have gotten my email about torture methods for cheating spouses.
What's a cheating spouse?
I wouldn't worry about it. It's something for the bad souls.
Okay.
You're doing an excellent job.
Thanks.
Should we order lunch?
Can we have snuggies?
That sounds great. I'll get that order started for us right away.
Hello. Okay. Here is for you.
This is Lucifer. What can I do for you? Ah, yes, Zeus. Yes, I received the email from Hera. Well, can you blame me for asking her for advice on this topic? She certainly has a lot of experience. Just a moment, please. Xander, I need your help.
Wah.
I need you to insult the person on the phone.
You shouldn't be mean to people.
You can be mean to this person. I give you permission. Just whatever comes to mind, he's being very rude.
Okay.
Excellent.
Hello?
Hey, Xander, how's it going?
Good. Miss Lucifer says I'm doing a good job.
I knew I'd find a soft spot in him.
Oh, it's you.
Nice to see you, too.
Where is Xander?
He's at home in paradise.
Oh.
You knew he was only going to be here while I was out of office.
I suppose.
I knew you two would get along. We've all seen how you are with Sharky. You're not nearly as scary as you'd like everybody to believe.
Oh, the thorn in my side has returned.
I knew you missed me.
Sure I did.
You know, I met Xander at the Rainbow Bridge while I was there visiting my good girl Ellie. He wanted to play with the animals there.
Is that so?
Yeah. He's pretty young. His family isn't in the afterlife yet.
No.
He could probably benefit from having a good role model.
That would probably be good for him.
You know, he attends the school for the afterlife kids. Maybe he'd like to come here and hang out after school?
That would be acceptable.
I'm sure it would. So what'd I miss?
Hello!
Xander, how was school today?
Good. I get real good at my weeding.
Hey, why is there a massive crowd of souls in the hallway?
Oh, there's always an influx of sales and Ouija boards this time of year.
What does that have to do with the crowd?
When mortals use the Ouija board to contact a specific soul, the soul is informed and they can return contact if they wish, and hell happens to have the best reception.
What's a Ouija board?
It's a game that mortals use to speak to souls.
Why can't they just talk?
It's not that easy. With a Ouija board, there's at least a chance that the soul will respond.
How do they talk back?
They spell out the words so that mortals can read them.
I'm good at reading now.
So what happens if no one answers the call? Do the boards just stay still?
They can, or sometimes mortals move the board of their own volition just to scare their friends, and sometimes...
Sometimes what?
Sometimes the younger demons like to play pranks on the mortals by leaving them quite horrific messages.
Shouldn't you do something about that?
I try, but it is hard to keep them out of there.
You should ask them to be nice.
Well, I guess it's a good thing I have an assistant for that.
Morning, morning, morning! What do we have to do today?
What in the hell is wrong with you?
Oh, I went to this cute little cafe run by fairies, and they made me this tea, and it was made with Aldrich blood, and it gave me so much energy. I'm so ready to tackle the day.
Cafe latte?
Yeah, they're so nice, and their drinks are amazing. Oh, Xander, I got you hot chocolate.
Thanks.
No, we do not need a 4-year-old hopped up on sugar in here.
I also got you a cookie.
Bob really let you leave there bouncing off the walls like that?
No, Cyrus.
A fucking course he did.
Oh, we should make a daily order. Oh, we could go there every day.
No! Lucifer, I need to talk to you. Duroc, I have asked you time and time again to please schedule a meeting before coming into my office. I need to discuss some issues that I'm having, and I need to discuss them now. Hope, please schedule Duroc a meeting and then escort him out.
What level you work on?
7.
I'm on break.
Cereal... Serial killer and sexual abuser got sent to level 7, and I cannot send him to level 9 without your approval.
How did he only get sent to level 7?
I've been conferring with the other demons, and none of us can figure it out. Here's his file.
Oh, fuck.
Okay, Hope, please call down to level 9 and let them know that he is on his way. Duroc, if you could please escort him down there. Thank you.
Thanks, boss.
Hey, kid, you ever use a crossbow?
Nope, 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 nope. Get out, get out, get out, get out, get out. Go away, go away. Now.
Hey.
Now look at me and this opportunity. It's standing right in front of me. One thing I know, it's only part luck and soul. I'm putting on my
talk about this expansion project you got going on.
Please do not start with me on this. We have to expand.
I understand. And
I mean, you've seen the growth of souls coming down here, and the reality is we just don't have enough space anymore.
Yes, but
I mean, it's not like this is enjoyable for me. More space equals more work to do.
I feel that. I really do.
I don't dislike the work, but sometimes it can be a lot, and I don't like to feel stressed.
I am aware, and that's why I'm here, but like—
I feel that expansion is the only option.
You cannot expand into other realms!
The expansion is not that extensive.
You have builders starting to tape off areas in paradise. You cannot take over other people's paradises!
If I may play devil's advocate.
Did you just hear yourself just then?
If more souls are being sent to hell, then that means fewer souls are being sent to paradise, so they don't really need that space.
I know you know that that is not how that works, not in any way.
I know, I was trying to believe my own words, but even I know that paradise is off limits.
You're gonna have to consider downsizing certain levels so there's room on others.
I really can't be my own advocate.
Dumbass.
Excuse me, are you Miss Hope?
That I am. What can I help you with?
I'm Xander's teacher. I was wondering if I could talk to you for a minute.
Of course. Is there something wrong?
Well, Xander's been acting a little more confrontational lately. Not necessarily bad, but more so bold.
How so?
He's been talking about battles and different types of weapons. It is very out of character for him, and, you know, I hate to ask, but do you and Lucifer allow Xander to hang around the punishment levels of hell?
No, I haven't taken him down there, and I seriously doubt Lucifer would, but I'll ask him if he has, and I'll talk to Xander about it.
Thank you. And like I said, it's nothing bad, just not like his usual self.
Thank you.
So, buddy, your teacher tells me that you're talking suddenly about battles and weaponry?
Yeah.
You don't normally like that stuff, bud. Why the sudden interest?
Mr. Duroc let me play with the toys in hell.
Duroc? Like level 7 Duroc?
Uh-huh.
And he let you see the battles down there?
Yeah, we have fun together.
I'm gonna fucking kill him. Hope, would you be able to push my meeting with Odin back by a half an hour? I'm expecting the expansion project focus group to be running late.
Okay.
Xander, where's Hope?
She went to level 7.
Did she say why?
Yeah, she says she gonna fucking kill Mr. Duroc.
Don't say fuck, Xander. What the fuck did he do?
Duroc!
What? Oh, shit.
Are you out of your fucking mind?
Usually, but what's the context?
You've been bringing Xander down here to play with weapons and watch battles, okay? You're not fighting a war down here. You are letting Xander watch souls get tortured.
Well, sometimes the souls battle each other, especially if we're particularly hungover and don't want to work.
You are so incredibly irresponsible. Xander is only 4.
Kid can't be protected from everything. Sometimes a little exposure is good for him.
He's fucking 4!
You're not his parent.
And what happens when his parents get to the afterlife? They find out that he's been playing with real swords and watching souls get tortured? How do you think they're gonna feel?
Fine. I'll stop bringing him down here. But just so you know, he's been having a great time. Probably an even better time than he has in that office of yours.
Oh, we have plenty of fun.
Repeating that to yourself doesn't make it true.
Go fuck yourself.
I like her. She's got spunk.
Has he made a decision yet?
Nuh-uh.
Come on, Lucifer, you've got to choose.
It's a difficult decision.
No, it's not. Okay, we either get burgers from the burger place, pho from the Thai place, kebabs from the Greek place, or tacos from the taco truck.
Xander should just pick.
I picked yesterday.
It's your turn in the rotation. What do you want? I already told you 5 times. I'm good with whatever. You're the only one who's having trouble right now.
Well, if we got burgers, what kind of burger? All-American, barbecue, mushroom, bacon, Swiss? If we got kebabs, would they be chicken, lamb, beef, and what about vegetables? And then there's...
No. No subcategorizing until you pick a place.
I'm really hungry.
Lucifer, come on, just pick something already.
Okay, fine. You know what? Just...
Xander, may I borrow your hat? Pick one. Thai place.
Ugh, pho is going to be so heavy on the stomach.
Oh my god, you're getting pho and you're gonna like it and you're gonna eat the whole damn thing.
All right, Lucifer, this is for you.
What on earth?
Building collapsed. Hundreds dead. Those are the soul files for those going to hell. You need to decide what levels they're going to.
And I thought today was going to be a slow day. Okay, I can already tell by a cursory glance that most of these souls are going to be going to therapy on levels 1 and 2.
Well, you have fun with that. I'm going to take your notes on the expansion project to heaven and see if God has any input, all right?
How's it going? Pretty much done. Would you be able to drop these files on their respective levels?
Sure thing.
Hope, you forgot this one for level 7.
You can take that one.
And does that have anything to do with the talk that you had with Duroc the other day?
Yes.
What happened?
He said I wasn't fun.
I feel like I'm missing context here.
He was taking Xander to level 7 to play, and I called him irresponsible, and he said that Xander won't have as much fun up here.
So prove him wrong. Make him see that you guys do have fun.
Oh, please. He's a stubborn ass.
Pot and kettle here, Hope.
He won't admit that we have fun here, even if he's wrong.
He actually has a lot of respect for you, Hope. He finds you fascinating.
And I think you're full of shit. Where's Xander?
He's playing with the hellhounds down the hall. Why?
Because I'm going to deliver these files, and I'm going to take Xander with me, and we're going to take the trapdoor slide ride because I'm fun. but not past level 6, because we're not gonna watch violence.
Pot and kettle indeed.
Lucifer, weird question. What is your current policy on selling souls?
Is this soul currently living, or are they in the afterlife?
Currently living.
What are the terms of the soul selling?
Oof, not good. She's willing to sell you her soul if you bring ill fate on her son and his wedding and marriage to her future daughter-in-law.
What in the hell is wrong with some people?
Don't ask me, I never did any of that shit.
Soul selling request denied. In fact, I have half a mind to get a fairy's blessing to bless the son and the daughter-in-law a happy marriage away from the mother.
That would be well deserved.
While you're at it, go ahead and put a note in the mother's file for me to have a little chat with her when she arrives.
You actually follow through with those?
Sometimes if it's a particularly boring week.
Hope this for you.
What's this? Have a little fun for once. Duroc.
He's trying to make you laugh.
He's patronizing me.
I think you're assuming the worst.
Bop it! Pull it! Twist it!
Yes. Yes, okay. Okay. Yes, I understand. I will get that sorted right away. Thank you for letting me know.
What's going on?
We've had an influx of souls for the torture levels being sent to level 1, and they've started to become violent towards the therapists and the other souls.
How did that happen?
We've had some trainees at the front desk, and they appear to be very overwhelmed.
Do you want me to go up there and help them?
Yes, and while you're there, can you please check to make sure that there are enough handbooks for the new kids?
You got it.
Hey, Red. You get my message?
I did, and I'll have you know I'm plenty of fun even without it.
I'm sure you are. Is that why you left a stick with your name on it in level 7?
I left it in the mud so you'd be sure it was me.
Self-roasting, are we?
I'm just beating you to the punch.
Wanna grab coffee?
I'm busy. I'm going up to the front desk to help out for a little bit.
Really? Let me come and help.
I can manage. But what you can do is go over to level 1, grab your souls, and take them to where they belong.
What?
I'll explain on the way. Come on.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So when a soul comes to the desk, you send them to the afterlife of their preferred belief system based on where they came out of judgment. But that's it. Don't send them to any particular level or area of that afterlife. That is up to the gate employees of that realm.
Thank you so much for helping us get settled again. These new kids are just so overwhelmed. Some of them barely even went through training.
It's no problem at all, and I made some extra copies of the handbook so that everybody can have one now.
The souls that were wrongfully on level 1 have been moved to their correct levels, and fortunately there was no lasting damage to the other souls or the therapists.
Oh, good. Do you guys need anything else from me?
Nope, I think we're all good here. Thank you so much again.
Anytime. I'll be seeing you guys around, all right? Don't work too hard.
You did a great job back there.
Was that a compliment?
I've been known to do that sometimes. How about that coffee?
Honestly, I am so exhausted. I'm ready to just go and crash for the night.
My place?
Funny.
Are you trying to avoid me?
I'm just trying to settle my brain.
What are you trying to settle?
Dating.
Bad past experiences?
Oh, yes.
I'm really not so bad.
I know you're not. The last date that I went on was in the mortal world, and it was...
What happened?
I wound up in the afterlife. I'll see you later.
Mr. Lucifer, when's Hope coming back?
I'm not sure, Xander. She said she was taking a few days off.
Why?
She didn't say, but she seemed sad.
I'm gonna make her a card so she feel better.
Lucifer, why didn't you tell me about how Hope died? Duroc, why do you always insist on barging in without an appointment? Why didn't you say anything?
It's not my business to reveal personal information about my staff, especially considering you never asked.
I never realized it was so bad. She's always so happy and positive.
Those who experience the worst usually want others to experience the best. What all did she tell you? That she went on a date and wound up here. Hope is a very happy and positive person. Her experiences have led her to be very protective over people that are good, like Xander, but she will also take no shit from people who treat her poorly, which is why she made such an impact at the help desk. I take it she's not coming in today? She said she needed to take a few days, and I'm guessing the reminder of what happened is why. I feel terrible. I'll give her some space until she comes back after a few days.
I'm making Hope a card to feel better. You want to sign it?
Yes, I would love to.
Hey, guys.
Hope's back!
Yeah, it's good to see you, bud.
I made you a card so you feel better.
Oh, thank you. Oh, it's beautiful. And you got everyone's signatures? Oh, thank you. I love it. Lucifer, where's your signature?
Meh, I don't like you very much.
You're full of shit.
Hope, as your employer, your business is your own, and I will not pry. However, as your friend...
We're not friends.
As your friend... Please know that you are welcome to talk about whatever you're feeling, and I will be more than happy to listen. Or at least pretend to listen.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
Now, would you like to discuss your absence, or would you like to just move forward as usual?
I would love nothing more than to just get right back into the swing of things, go right back into afterlife as normal.
Understood. And good thing, too, because I have a whole list of things that need to be done today.
Thank you for calling the office of Lucifer. This is Hope. How may I help you?
Hope. I didn't realize you were back in office.
Oh, hey. Yeah, I just got back yesterday.
Great. Could I maybe meet with you to talk?
Sure. I can come down to level 7 if you want.
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Hey.
Hi. I just wanted to apologize to you in person.
For what?
I shouldn't have been pushing the idea of a date on you without realizing that it would be a trigger. I should not have put you in that position.
It's not your fault. You had no way of knowing. And despite how I may act, I don't hate our banter. Sometimes.
I just hate that I put you in a place where you felt so bad that you needed to take time off.
You have nothing to apologize for. I did what I normally do when I'm feeling upset, which is I went and screamed into the void for a few days, and then I came back and just picked up where I left off.
Well, I won't pester you about a date anymore. I'm gonna leave that up to you. But I'm always here as a sounding board, should you need one.
Do you know what I hate?
What?
I hate that he didn't just ruin my life. Like, maybe if I was the only one who was hurt when I died, then maybe I would be able to rest easy. But he destroyed the lives of every person around me. My parents, my siblings, my grandparents, my friends, hell, even my colleagues. He ripped apart the lives of every single person surrounding me, and he couldn't give two shits about it.
How long you been holding that in?
A while.
What can I do to best comfort you right now?
Would it be weird if I just sat down on the floor here and did nothing for a while?
No, it wouldn't be weird. Can I sit with you?
If you want.
Thank you for calling the office of Lucifer. This is Hope. How may I help you?
Hey, we need help.
Hi, may I ask who's calling?
Yeah, my name's Oren, and my buddy Varen is in a bit of a situation.
Dude, I told you not to call them. We're gonna get in so much trouble.
Can you please give me more information on what your problem is?
Well, we're on level 8, and Varen is stuck in something, and we can't get him out.
Aren't all employees supposed to have keys to the traps? Couldn't you just use one of those?
Well, we're not exactly employees.
If you were sent to level 8, then there is a good reason for that, and we are not going to do anything.
No, we're not souls. We don't work down here.
How old are you?
15. We kind of just snuck down here so we could see what it was like.
And why can't you ask one of the level 8 employees to assist you?
Well, they all went on a lunch break. Like, are you going to be able to help us or not?
Yeah. Don't get your panties in a twist. Let's figure this out. What's Varen stuck in?
I'm not sure. It's a mortal trap, I think. It's like sharp and spiky with a mouth.
Do you have any other information you could give me?
Yeah. It's like that thing from Saw.
That did not narrow it down even in the slightest.
Yeah. You know, the thing on the girl's head that's gonna make it snap.
Mouth over the head. Do you mean a bear trap?
Yeah, that's definitely it.
Okay, I'm going to make a call to maintenance that Varen got his foot stuck in a bear trap.
Oh, well, it's not his foot.
Oh, his tail.
Nah, it's his elbow.
How did he get his elbow stuck in a bear trap?
Don't tell her, man. You already embarrassed me enough.
He tripped over his tail.
He tripped over your tail?
Nah, his tail.
Okay, someone from maintenance will be down to get you out of there, okay? Please stay calm until then. Goodbye. You know, I'd say you're going to hell for laughing, but the environment really ruins that joke.
This is Lucifer. How may I help you? Is that so? Okay, I will assist you in the interview process, and I would like you and the other faculty to help make the final decision.
So you're doing really, really well writing out your letters, but with your lowercase g, you want to make sure that the hook goes to the left and not to the right, because otherwise it's a Q.
Okay.
In the meantime, I can send in a substitute. Absolutely. Have a great day. Hope, you were a teacher in your mortal life, correct?
Yep. Mostly with the older elementary school kids, like 4th and 5th graders, but there was one year that I taught kindergarten.
Wonderful. So one of the teachers at the Demon School is going on maternity leave a little earlier than initially expected, and we're looking to find a long-term substitute until she returns. But until then, we were hoping that you would be able to fill in?
I mean, maybe, but I don't know what gets taught at the Demon School.
Well, these students are a little older, and the class you would be teaching is Mortal Studies, which is why I thought of you for the job.
Mortal Studies? Really?
Yes, you would be discussing mortal history and important events, and of course there would be rough lesson plans that you would be able to follow. Are you interested?
I don't know. I haven't taught in a long time.
You would only be filling in until a long-term sub can be found, so I can't imagine that you're going to be there for very long.
I mean, I guess.
Perfect. You'll start in a few days.
Great. That'll find me some time to find the teacher voice again.
Daily affirmation, repeat after me.
I am not the bigger person. I am the smaller person who is prone to pyromania.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Hope, and I'm going to be filling in for your teacher, Miss...
I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. I will definitely butcher it. It says here that you guys are currently learning about why mortals might get sent to hell. Can anybody give me an example of something you've already covered? Yes.
Murder.
Great example. Anybody else? You.
Stabbing.
Okay, that kind of falls into the realm of murder. Do we have any non-murder related examples? Excuse me, can we put the phones away, please?
I don't plan on going into torturing, so I don't need this.
Whatever your future plans are, presently you are in my classroom and I'm going to need you to put your phone away.
Whatever.
Thank you. So I thought we could start by talking about some of the lesser thought of reasons why people might be sent to hell, and I figured we would start off with the bystander effect. Now, one of the more famous cases of the... Okay, I can see that you still have your phone out, so I'm going to have to confiscate that.
No way, I'm not giving my phone to some fairy. This is my personal property.
Fairy? I'm a mortal soul, and I'm also in charge of you today, so hand over the phone.
You're pointed at your safe, fairy.
Only one of my ears is pointed, and that's more of a birthmark thing than a fairy thing, so hand over your phone, Oren.
No.
You sound familiar. Have you been on level 8 recently?
No.
Really? Haven't been down to level 8 with your buddy Varen? No one got stuck in a bear trap?
How do you know about that?
I have my ways. So are you going to hand over the phone? Thank you. Teenagers. So, the bystander effect.
Lucifer!
What the fuck is wrong with you?
I'm watching the new Haunted Mansion movie and I have a question.
It is fascinating how you can come face to face with Hades without batting an eye, but a movie gets you all wound up.
So there's this seance, right? Okay, and they're all gathered together trying to contact the guy who used to own the mansion so they can find out why everybody's being haunted. Now they gave him a pad and a pen so he can write down his responses.
Okay.
Like, is that actually a thing?
I feel like you could have just researched this yourself, but yes, it is a thing.
How did I not know that? That's freaking awesome!
It's not the beginner's choices for seances, and you and I both know that you have very little knowledge on the topic.
Okay, now the kid is having his dad communicate with him through the pad and paper, all right? There's no medium and there's no seance. How is that possible?
Well, one possibility is that it is a demonic entity trying to trick the child, but I think the more obvious possibility is that it is a fucking movie!
You have no sense of creativity. It was a demon trying to trick him.
Sometimes I wonder how it is possible that you are an adult.
Okay, we are almost out of here. Do you guys have any more questions before we take off?
What public service positions are going to be covered on the test?
Anything that we covered yesterday or today. So that's police officers, firefighters, nurses, first responders, corrections officers, and any branch of the military. Now remember, you guys have to identify which professions are more likely to have a person sent to hell, all right? Okay, we're going to spend the first 5 minutes of class tomorrow going over any questions you might have before the test, okay? Y'all have a great rest of your day, okay? Be good people.
Hi, Hope.
Hey, Xander, what are you doing here?
We wanted to take you to lunch.
To congratulate you on your return to teaching. It's only till they find a long-term sub. Still, for you. Thank you. You know, I'm surprised you guys have this tradition in hell. We don't, but I researched mortal teacher gifts and apples came up quite frequently. I don't really understand it. I don't really get it either, but I love apples, so thank you.
Mr. DeWalk said we could play with the toys in hell today.
Just the fake ones for the kids. Don't need to be getting lectured by you again. Although you seem to be putting your lecturing to good use now. Cute.
Are you going to play with us?
I suppose. Hope, do you have Jesus's extension number? Jesus's office extension. Do you remember the number?
Yeah, it's the sign of the cross.
I'm
actually looking for a number.
Yeah, that's right.
What has got you so distracted?
Grading tests.
Would you be able to take a break and help me out with this?
I'm in the zone. Ask Xander to do it.
Xander is currently helping Hermes with deliveries. He likes the flying shoes.
They are super fun.
How are the kids doing?
Most of them are doing really well. I'm just gonna toss this question out. Most of them got it wrong. Oh, do you remember that kid, Oren, who called down here because he and his buddy were on level 8 and his buddy was, like, stuck in a bear trap?
A bear trap? How could I forget?
Your sympathy is heartwarming. Anyway, Oren's in my class. He had no idea that I was the one who took that call.
Is he as smart as he sounds?
He's actually not doing awesome in my class, and it's a shame because I can tell he's, like, a really smart kid. He's just not applying himself.
Can you help him?
I don't even know if there's anything I can do. I mean, I'm not a doctor, so I can't say if he needs any sort of accommodation. And I don't even think I'm able to talk to him or his parents about it because I'm only a short-term sub until they can find someone more permanent. I mean, honestly, it would be super helpful if he came directly to me and asked me for help.
Maybe he'll warm up to you.
I don't know. Did you say you needed something?
Oh, yes. I need the extension number for Jesus's office.
Oh, I told you, it's the sign of the cross. 2046.
Oh.
Miss Hope, do you have a second?
Yes. Oh, hey, Oren, what's up?
Would I be able to retake last week's test?
Yes, but I would actually like to go over the material with you again and see where you were struggling.
I'm not struggling. My mom's just gonna be pissed at me if I come home with a D.
Really? You're not struggling at all?
Told you before, I don't need this class. I just have to take it to graduate.
Well, that being said, a retake of the test isn't going to do you any good if you don't review the material first.
I'll just study harder this time.
Oren, I hate to do this because I'm not your regular teacher, but I am not going to let you take a retest unless you let me go over the material with you again.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Don't swear at me. And yeah, I'm not going to let you retake the test if you don't let me help you.
I don't need help.
Then I guess you're not retaking the test.
Are you Miss Hope?
I am. Can I help you?
I'm Oren's mother, and I would like to know why you won't let him retake his test. He took the initiative to come to you and ask very politely if he could retake his test, and you just told him no.
Ma'am, that is simply not true. Oren came to me and asked if he could retake his test, and I said I would let him if he would let me review the material with him first, but he insisted that he did not want to do so, and I personally don't believe that retaking the test without a review session would be beneficial.
Is this true?
I don't know, maybe.
I am so sorry. I jumped to conclusions based on what my son said. I realize I should have gotten both sides of the story first.
I completely understand, and it's quite all right. If you'll let me, I would love for us to work together to help Oren reach his full potential.
That would be wonderful. Thank you.
Of course. Let's talk about what we can do moving forward.
Are you guys serious right now?
One of the most surprising prehistoric weapons was actually the boomerang, which, interestingly enough, were not designed to be returned back to the user.
I am so sorry, guys.
Sorry about that, guys. Now, boomerangs are no longer used as practical weapons, but they can be found used as psychological weapons down on levels 5 and 6. Now, we're going to move into ancient Egyptian weaponry, which is going to... I am so sorry, guys. I'm going to take this real quick. Lucifer, the very fabric of the universe, must be fraying apart for you to be calling me while I am teaching.
Hope, I need to know where the keys to the filing cabinet are. No. Excuse me?
I refuse to believe that you are calling me simply because you could not find the keys to your filing cabinet.
I have to get the expansion project notes to the builders by this afternoon. The notes are in the filing cabinet, and it's locked. I have turned this office upside down looking for the keys.
If you had just given the notes to the builders earlier this week, like I told you to, you wouldn't be scrambling now.
Shoulda, coulda, woulda. Do you know where the keys are?
Top left drawer in my desk.
Why are my keys in your desk?
Because I knew you would lose them. Do not fucking call me again. I am teaching.
Rude.
Guys, unrelated lesson. Never take on a leadership role on a whim. Think things through. Otherwise, you could wind up ruling an entire realm and still can't even keep track of some fucking keys!
Xander, would you be able to do me a favor?
Okay.
Deliver this paperwork down to level 7.
Hope says I'm not allowed down there anymore.
Well, she is just a smidge overprotective, isn't she?
She says I'm too young to be down there.
Hope isn't going to find out, and I am giving you permission to go down to level 7. Duroc is down there. You know Duroc. Just give the paperwork to him and then come right back.
Okay. Mr. Duroc!
Whoa, Xander. What are you doing down here?
Mr. Lucifer says to give you this.
You know Hope doesn't like you being down here.
Mr. Lucifer says that Hope isn't gonna find out, so it's okay.
That woman has super senses, and I am not convinced that she won't find out. Why don't we get you back to-
I don't want another pretty face. I don't want just anyone.
Hey, Hope.
Hey, I'm writing my lesson plans for tomorrow, and I wanted to know what mortal weapons you guys are using on level 7. Like, I also want to know, like, what severity they're used at. Like, a soft level 7 versus, like, a hard level 7.
Hi, Hope!
Was that Xander?
No, that was just one of the new trainees on this level. Is Xander down there with you? He might be.
Fucking hell. Mr. Lucifer asked me to bring papers down here for Mr. Duwak.
So this is Lucifer's fault? Yes.
As if he wasn't already at the top of my shit list.
What's a shit list?
Lucifer, before you say anything, let me remind you that I am the Master of Hell and your boss.
You seem to be expecting a lecture. What on earth could I possibly be angry about?
This feels like a trick question.
Lucifer, it seems that I need to remind you that I do not want you sending our 4-year-old trainee down to the torture levels, nor do I want you interrupting my teaching time.
And I would like to remind you that you are my assistant, which means that I need you to be available.
Ah, yes, another reminder that you are the one who asked me to teach at the demon school in the first place.
You assured me that you would be able to handle both.
I can, and I do, when you're not disturbing me.
Hope,
Lucifer, I am only going to say this once. You need me here so you can efficiently run your domain. You can't do this without me. So don't piss me off, or else hell can and will be redefined for you. Do you understand me?
Yes.
Great. I have class in a few minutes, and then after that, I will be back to help you with the rest of the day.
I'm done.
All right, let me just look over this. While I do, can I ask you a question?
What?
Well, you keep saying you don't want to go into torturing. So why were you and Varen lurking around on level 8? It can get pretty intense down there.
I don't know. It seemed cool, I guess.
What do you want to do when you graduate?
I don't know.
You don't want to tell me, or you don't know?
I don't know what I want to do, okay?
Do you have any hobbies?
What do you care?
I do care, Oren, okay? I want you to succeed, and I want you to do something that makes you feel happy.
Whatever.
Really? I'm trying to help you, and you're just going to sit there and give me attitude? All right, well, you did better on this worksheet, but
There's something else I want to talk to you about.
My hopes and dreams.
Funny. No, actually, I want to ask how you feel about reading.
I don't like to read much.
Is that because you're having trouble?
What?
I've noticed that during our review sessions, you are reading a little slower, and you regularly fight me on reading out loud, which I've noticed are common signs of dyslexia. I'm not a specialist, but I have had dyslexic students in the past, and you share some very strong similarities. Why haven't you told anybody you're struggling? Oren, look at me. Look at me and continue to look at me.
Imagine being the only 15-year-old who can't read. You know how embarrassing that is?
Okay. Here's what we're going to do. We are going to meet with an intervention specialist, and they're going to assist us with getting you some accommodations. We don't have to tell anybody else if you don't want to. But we do need to tell your mom.
Promise you won't tell anyone else.
Scout's honor.
You were a scout?
Eh, I was in Brownies for like 2 years when I was in like kindergarten, so I think it counts.
Like we've got a ton of requests for souls to be sent to hell.
Sounds about right. Most of them deserve to be down here anyway, but it does help us to get ahead on organizing.
Retail employee wants their boss to be sent to hell for underpaying staff and general dickery. Would have been sent to hell without the request, but it is certainly helpful.
Woman wants her neighbor sent to hell because he parked his truck on her property and destroyed her yard in the process. Sounds like a level 3 to me.
Lady kicked a doggy.
I'll take that one. Animal abusers are the fucking worst.
Fucking worst.
Don't say fuck, Xander. Man wants his ex-girlfriend sent to hell for dumping him.
Why'd she dump him?
Just wasn't interested anymore.
Oh, well, sounds like that guy will be taking up residence down here when the time comes.
It would appear so. Woman wants the designer of the heels that she was wearing to be sent to the lowest level of hell, citing torture as the motive.
Oh, that one's from me.
Really? Torture?
Have you ever worn heels?
Never mind.
Happy Halloween!
I always forget about this mortal holiday. It's spooky enough in hell as it is. What is this supposed to be?
I'm simply taking advantage of the situation, something I can see you are avoiding.
I am not avoiding anything. I simply see no reason to celebrate a holiday where the dead are blending with the living. We are literally surrounded by the living dead here.
I just think you're a Grinch. A spooky season Grinch.
It's time for candy!
AKA, the best part of spooky season.
Xander, what's your costume?
I'm my friend Shulky.
I'm sure they'd be very proud. You guys ready to go trick-or-treating?
Yes!
Where are you guys going?
We are hitting up a few paradise locations, and then we might be stopping by heaven if we're feeling up to it. Where's your costume?
I'm brand new.
Do neither of you have any fun?
Candy time, candy time.
Come on, Mr. Bright, Shiny, and New.
Duroc, a moment. If you're going to have sex with Hope, I must ask that you not do so while she is wearing that costume.
It's none of your business. But I would never do that while she looks like you. Full offense.
Make sure Xander gets home at a reasonable hour.
Tweet, 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 tweet!